Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. This is the part 6 video in this series. So let's move to next question. Question number 18. You have downloaded an Azure Resource Manager template to deploy numerous virtual machines. The ARM template is based on current virtual machine but must be adapted to reference an administrative password. You need to make sure that the password cannot be stored in plain text. You are preparing to create the necessary components to achieve your goal. Which of the following should you create to achieve your goal? Answer by dragging and correct option. So it was drag and drop, but we have copy paste here. In this question, keyword is that password cannot be stored in plain text. That means we have to use password management service. So that will be the part of our solution here. So let's see what are the options are provided here. An Azure Key Vault. So basically Azure Key Vault is a cloud service for securing and storing and accessing secrets. Secret is anything that you want to tightly control access to, such as API keys, for example, passwords, certificates, cryptography keys. So definitely if we don't want to expose our password or secure our password, in that case this will be one option we need to select. Let's see another one. An Azure storage account. Storage account has nothing to do with the password in this case. That takes care of storage part. So this is not the one. We can proceed. The third one is Active Directory Identity Protection. Identity protection actually helps organization to detect and investigate, remediate identity based risk. So that is something different. It has nothing to do with the password management. Then the next option is access policy. The access policy is tightly coupled with the Azure keyword service, and basically this is a keyword access policy that determines that whatever the security principle like user application or user group can perform different operations on keyword secrets and keys and certificates. So definitely this will be useful for us in this answer. The next one is Azure policy. Azure policy has nothing to do with the password, and it is used to enforce organizational standards and access compliance. So this is not part of our answer. And the backup policy, that is also something to do with the backup, nothing to do with the password. So to secure the password which cannot be stored in plain text, I think we can use the keyword service and implement the access policy. So this is correct, number one, and this is also included. So these two options are part of answer. Let's move to next question. Question number 19. Your company's Azure subscription include two Azure network name, virtual network network A and virtual network B. Virtual network A includes VPN gateway that is configured to make use of static routing. Also site-to-site VPN connection exists between your company's on-premise network and virtual network A. You have configured a point-to-site VPN connection to virtual network A from a workstation running Windows 10. After configuring virtual network peering between virtual network A and virtual network B, you confirm that you are able to access virtual network B from company's on-premise network. However, you find that you cannot establish a connection to virtual network B from Windows 10 workstation. You have to make sure that a connection to virtual network B can be established from Windows 10 workstation. So this is a little bit lengthy and puzzling question. And the solution is provided. You choose allow gateway transit setting on virtual network A. Does the solution meet the goal? So definitely this solution or this step is needed, but is it fulfilling or you know, are we able to connect from Windows 10 workstation in this case? That we have to make sure. So we'll create a little diagram here to understand. So this is our diagram as per our question, where we do have two virtual networks, virtual network A and B. And in virtual networks, we have gateway or site to site connectivity between our on premise and virtual network A, and the peering is in place between both the virtual networks. And virtual machines in virtual network B are we are able to connect virtual machines of B into our on premise network. It means that connectivity is working through virtual network A, so that part is confirmed in the question itself. But we are not able to connect our workstation to the network B, so that connectivity is not working. So this is supposed to work in this way, which is not working right now. We have to figure it out. There is a key component which is allow transit setting. So that is implemented on virtual network A. It means the and also we are confirming that in site to site connectivity we are able to connect with the virtual network B items into our on premise location. That means there is nothing wrong with the connectivity part, this is for sure. So what exactly is stopping Windows 10 workstation from connecting to virtual network B is that is a VPN client which is installed on the virtual machine, or not on virtual machine, on the workstation. This is, we need to maybe restart that VPN client, or we need to reinstall that VPN client. So that VPN client, once it is up to date or restarted, it will allow us to connect with the virtual network B. So in this case, we'll again go to the question. The answer for this question is no, because we have to restart the VPN client on the workstation, then only it's going to work. It's not going to work just allowing this setting. I hope this video was informative for you. So please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And please turn on the notification, because on daily basis I am uploading one video or two videos, is depending on my time availability. So thank you very much for watching this video.